Hello, hello and welcome. Thank you for having me here. I hope I'm standing in the right spot now. Okay. So, yes, I'm here. Thank you for the invitation. I just wanted to share with you a little bit what we are doing in Harman. You see, we're saying Huemen here. I will explain you in a moment why Huemen, Harman, what it has to do with this. First of all, we are Harman. We are a design team inside Harman. I get to this in a moment. We got founded a couple of years back because we identified Harman has been growing over the last couple of years by acquiring different companies. They always had their different design teams, the different designers inside. This could be industrial designers, UI UX designers, and we put them all together in one group. We wanted to use the synergies from the designers, and we have a team with actually 250 designers now in Harman, globally. We are called Huemen. We called ourselves Huemen. So the first of all, we called ourselves the agency, and we asked all the designers in the team, so how should we call ourselves? What kind of name do we give to the child? And one designer came up, okay, we do the design for the people down there on the road. Why don't we call ourselves Huemen, right? So, and I think that's pretty fair. We have the design for the headphones. Maybe you know Harman has multiple brands like JBL, Harman Kardon. We do all these corporations with Bowers & Wilkins, Bang & Olufsen, and so on. We do speakers, entertainment, infotainment. We do headphones products for the people who are on the road, but also for vehicles. And this is mainly what my area of expertise is. Setting up this agency, we were looking for a nice spot, and what could be nicer than being in Manhattan in New York. So, but it's not only because it's nice, but we have the headquarter of Harman is very close by in Stamford, Connecticut. So it's just a 45-minute train ride into Grand Central, and there we have our studio, and it's very nice, very customer-facing, and this is where we mainly operate with corporate identity, with brand identity, and so on. So I already introduced New York. This is where we are as well. We call them anchor studios, so we are located globally. In automotive, we have a slightly different setup, a slight modification to this setup, and it looks like this. My team is working out of Detroit to cover the market and relation with the OEMs in North America. We are in Munich. This is where I'm located right now as well, where we cover all the relations with the European OEMs. We set up a studio in Suzhou for China that I haven't seen for the last 3 years, actually. It's very good to be close to the customers, to speak the same language and to understand them, right? And not to translate this. We are in Seoul to cover Hyundai, Kia, Genesis. In Japan, we have a lot of customers across Toyota and a few of other ones. You might have seen the name Huemen. It's a little bit strange. You might realize that we have misspelled the name Huemen, but we did this on purpose. We called it H-U-E. That has some legal background, but we have the term hue in it because it's very diverse. It has the different tonalities, the different shades. And we have it because you have seen it with the world map. We have a very diverse team, and I think a very key aspect of our team is that we understand the language of our customer, we understand the philosophy, the background, and we know how to speak with them. And I think this drives a lot of loyalty. This hue, I think, for me, stands also for this diversity in brands that we own, that we're working on. You might see that there are 8 brands that we have in the Harman portfolio. Maybe some of you have heard about JBL. Maybe Harman Kardon. There are other brands that are not so popular. There's actually a UK-based brand. Maybe you spot them. It's Arkem. It's a brand that was founded in the UK, and a few other brands. I would not go too deep into those. That's another session. But something that's special in automotive is also that we have collaborations, because we believe that there is, especially in the premium and high-end brands, there is a need for our customers to have more more options, right? So we want to have more more opportunities to separate, right? Not everybody wants to have the same brands in the segment. So we have collaborations with a team called Sound United. They own a brand like Bowers & Wilkins and a few other brands out of Vista, California. And Bang & Olufsen, and Bang & Olufsen is very close to my heart. This is where I started my career many years ago, living in Denmark, getting to know the production, the philosophy of the, about the brand. And this is it's a really beautiful brand because it comes with a lot of history, with 90 years of history, so to say. The Hue also stands for the diversity that we have in our products. This is JBL. You might not recognize the similarity between the two products, but this is all JBL. So how can we bridge this gap, then bringing this also in automotive? We have these stadium speakers that you might have seen in an arena, in a concert, hanging down these huge rigs. But then you also have these little clip speakers, the Clip 4, for example. That's what all the teenagers have on their bathing suits, jumping into pools and having parties. Right? But how does it come together, right? It's all about maybe entertainment. So we're successful, 250 designers, like I said, over 500 design awards in automotive. We this is what we've got this year. Harman is very proud about this. So we are the only company that's also a competitive factor in the industry. No one else is actually doing it. Like we are winning these awards for our customers to show them like really this is added value that we are bringing on the table. So when you read this one now, Huemen, maybe you know a little bit better where this name is coming from. So it's the design for the people with all its different diversities. And I show you a little video now, what we're doing mainly on the car audio side. I want to show you a little bit more there because this is more related to the to today, to the event today, about prototyping and the work that we're doing. The video is about already 3 years old. After this, I go and make a little more deep dive into what we're doing today. So you will see there is a, the date is different and the location is different. But have a look at this. I think it explains already quite a bit. Thank you. see, we do a co-branded product. So for the automotive, that's sometimes our challenge, that we're not really like doing the product like a mixer or a coffee machine or a speaker for home consumer ourselves, but we are always in this relation with the customer. That's why this is really, really important for us to add this glue to this customer relationship that we're driving. And for this, we have established, because we cannot always be there on site, we have as a baseline some kind of design guidelines that we have established that where we explain the basics of each of these brands. This is what we're doing for all the different brands. So these are very much like requirements that we are providing to our customers. Like, what is it that you need to fulfill to apply that specific brand in your car? But we're also doing other elements. Like, we're providing more guideline. We are creating these boxes. We call them bento boxes. These are material boxes where we explain what materials deserve to be in that specific spot. What materials do we believe should be in this? When you purchase a Harman Kardon system, like a classic system for Harman Kardon, then this is the area where we feel comfortable in. So this is where we're going. We're bringing this to our customers, and we're showing them, okay, this is the pattern design that we would like to apply. This is the materials that would be in the surrounding of it. And we are having a close alignment with acoustics, with our branding team, so that this is messages really on the spot. And then there are opportunities that we want to provide to our customers to not only use this kind of level, but also maybe come up with a more exclusive version, or maybe with something that is more affordable, like an entry solution. So we're scaling them down, we're scaling them up, and we're providing from our design team these solutions. So this is an example we have done for Harman Kardon to show you like the bandwidth of opportunities that we have, because sometimes we end up having like, can we have one brand in an entry segment, and then we're stepping up and we end up having three or four different brands. But I think there is enough potential in all of our individual brands to scale them up and scale them down. And we're doing this for multiple brands. I just want to show you a few examples. So this one we are just doing for Revel as a brand. So what does this brand actually look like? And we're heard a couple of other presentations today where we look about sustainable materials. So for Revel, for example, that's an American-based brand born out of Harman. We are proposing Karoon as a material. That's a material used in, maybe you've seen it, the Neo vehicles they have, and in the steering wheels. It's a material that you actually have to harvest rainforest or grow rainforest to be able to harvest this material. And then it has a couple of fibers. So what is beautiful about it, you can use it in along the fibers or across the fibers, then it actually provides some kind of transparency, not necessarily for speakers, but there's a high impact in illumination and light, for example. So these are these boxes that we are sharing to give an idea what the system level might look like. And there are also options, not only in Harman Kardon, but also in Revel, there are also options to scale it up and to create more premium experiences here. And what we're doing on the physical side with all these materials, we're also doing on the digital side with design systems where we explain, okay, how's the, because the brand is not only about the physical assets that we have in the car. We realize more and more that the customers are shifting away from applying speaker grills in the car. It's pretty expensive having a stainless steel grill or plastic grills in multiple locations in the car. And then it needs to be exchanged for other audio options. So the digital implementation of a brand becomes a much, much higher footprint in the car in the future. And also another trend we see is that these physical components, they might actually lean back and we have much more integrated solutions. So we are really always asking for early integrations with our customers. And this is what a brand looks like when we receive it on our table. And then this is how the communication. This was done by our team in New York, a photo shoot last, I think, during COVID. You can't see this there, but they were all tested, and we have done this beautiful photo shoot, I think in a villa close to New York. This is how we perceive the brand Mark Levinson. You see all these products, you see all these, you see the amplifiers there. Mark Levinson is an amplifier brand. You see these mid-century modern furniture, you see these elegant people there. You see even the interface on these amplifiers, there's a little, these red icons there. This is, it has a little bit of these 80s arcade game style. So it's quite cool. I think the how the brand is being presented is pretty nice. But how does it mean? Like, people ask us, what does it mean to bring this into a car? And how do we perceive this? And first of all, it's not only about us, like I said before, it's about the cooperation we're having. And I just wanted to highlight this one. This is in Japan, cooperation we have with Lexus. And we're looking into future models, into concept cars, what's the trend that the design team is aiming for. How can we find the best of both worlds and combine this? Right? It's a little bit like in a marriage, right? So where are these elements that that you're sharing? And we are developing all of these requirements and stuff like this, but then we also want to inspire our customers, and we want to show how does this brand come alive in the vehicle. And I remember very much like one moment where we visited a customer, and we told him, yes, we can do a beautiful interior design for your cars. And we started up with a couple of sketches, and it looked like a future vision of their interior with dynamic lines, everything very much automotive inspired. And this was, I think, a turning point in my career where he turned back on us and he said, like, I don't want to see this. I have 50 designers behind me. They're all doing car design. Why do I need you? I said, why? Maybe you're right. Maybe you're right. Maybe I think what we should bring on the table is more inspiration from where we are coming from, telling more a story. What is this audio brand? How do we see it? How can we see really this essence coming alive in the car? And we came actually up by doing this, not trying to be honest and true to ourselves, where we create these kind of, we call them atmospheres, and this is more like a very naive interpretation of the brand. You see elements of what I explained to you before about this very elegant like living room with this mid-century modern furniture and stuff like this. All of these elements are in there. It's not a car, it's just inspiration with a little twinkle in your eyes. Have a look at this yourself. this arcade mode interface, right? So, and this shelf there that inspires you of a dashboard in this mid-century modern furniture. So I think that's quite nice. Like doing this, showing this to the design studios, they open the doors, right? No one wants to see all the time requirements, and going there with a whip and saying like, hey, you have to do this, you have to stop doing this, and so on. So we changed our rhythm a little bit, and we rather go into this direction. We want to inspire the people, showing them what great assets do we have with our brands. To give you an example also how we can scale this, there's an example with the boxes you saw previously in the different levels. So we're going in here with reused plastic into a more classic mode, and then with something that is more inspired by the sound sticks. I show you these sound sticks. This is a product that we have launched in the consumer market. Maybe some of you know it. It's a very classic product. It actually goes back to, maybe some of you remember this, these computers, these iMacs with the different colors that were launched by Apple. And around this time, there was a need to create, on top of these tweeters that you can put on your table, on the side of your screens, there was a need to create these a subwoofer, to have a little bit more bass. So there was actually a team around Jonas Knife who created this this woofer, very acrylic, so it matches these screens. And since then, we have continued to develop the sound sticks. And now this is, I think, also Sound Sticks 4. I think a very beautiful product. The earliest one from the 20th century is in the Museum of Modern Art. So this is a beautiful link to a long history. We see all of these details, and we thought, sometimes we have this as an exercise, and we think, can't we bring this into a vehicle as well? And how does it look like? So we were trimming this one, and we thought, how cool could this look when you just shorten it a little bit? Maybe you have seen in the previous video these ALTs, we call them. It's these acoustic lenses from Bang & Olufsen that are raising in the dashboard. It's always a really nice element. It's not just a gimmick. The idea of those ones is we want to give the stage to our partners, because you're buying the vehicle because you like an Audi. You admire this car, you want to drive the car. But then when you turn on the music while driving, then suddenly the main act comes on stage, and then there is a full performance of this sound system. Otherwise, it's hidden. We take ourselves in the second row. But then once we come on stage, we are very present. And here we have something similar, but we have it on a different brand. Not Bang & Olufsen, but this is just a design attempt. It's not in the market, it's just inspiration. It's just a way to explain how we can bring an idea from a product into automotive. So, giving you an idea, like for us it's really important to address this holistic design experience, and it's not only about these requirements, stainless steel grills. A friend of mine has just said, like, I got introduced to somebody, and somebody said, like, oh, he's the guy who puts just the stickers in the car, right? And she's true, right? That might be true to some extent. There's just a sticker, but in the end, there's much more that comes with the sticker, and we bring this to life. And this is how we can bring it to life. We have these very jewelry piece items with a tweeter on top or an ALT on the dashboard. And we cover all these disciplines across classic industrial design, UI and UX. And we always make sure that that whatever you find in the consumer side at your home, that we're bringing this experience, that we bring the product, basically, the product experience into your vehicle as well. And it starts very simple, and important for us is consistency. And this is what we are have achieved already with our young design studio that we're having across very strong customers. With Volvo, we have a very, very consistent integration of Harman Kardon. Same with Volkswagen and with BMW and Mini. And we really start, like, I think this is an element or an area of the presentation that gets leaning very much to the event today. We are modeling and building in our team these speaker components and these grills ourselves. We are mainly working on Rhino 3D because this has proven to be the best tool with where we get a lot of talents as well. And we also work with we work a lot with Grasshopper as a tool that applies the parametric surfaces in there. Also, there are other solutions in the market, but we believe right now that also the talent pool that we have with Grasshopper is the biggest so far. So doing a speaker grill is not so easy. So I just wanted to highlight a few things and why we're actually doing this. So why are we doing a speaker grill and why is this so important? Right? Maybe you look at the first picture and these are the things like not having a speaker grill is also not an option, right? Some of you have kids maybe, right? You know what I'm talking about? Put the finger into that thing and it's broken. So then for sure we have it for, we need to look at the acoustic performance, brand synthesis, like how we merge the brands together, and also how the grill is produced. I'm diving a little bit deeper into this in a moment, but things have been in the past very, very difficult for us, like designing this speaker grill design, bringing like the philosophy of the brand and also with all these requirements together has been very challenging. So we were looking for an opportunity how to optimize this. And very often we realized in this process, once we have done the design, that it's not performing that well. And we have to go all the way back to the beginning onto the drawing board, into Illustrator, and I don't know, into the basics of Rhino to develop something new. Go maybe into develop some of these production samples. It's not, we can go into rapid prototyping, but then it's not really true to the acoustic. Is very sensitive. So when you do this, it's important that you do the grill in stainless steel or in aluminium. With Bang & Olufsen, we have a great control of the production in, we call it Factory 5 in Denmark, in Struer, a little village up north. But it takes time until we get this result back. And we can take all of this, we need to take all of this into consideration and then go back again and say, okay, what is the transparency actually on all of these grills? So that's something that's really challenging us, and we identified this as a need where we need to improve. So there are so many things about the grill, and I think we can go on forever with what, well, grills, what is important for that. But it's important, like, what is the, I don't go into all of those, but the speaker location, right? We are that's why we want to have a very early engagement with our partners. We often say we want to be invited in their design studios when the clay is still wet, when we're able to move the speakers in the right location so that we get the best performance out of this. So the location is very important. It's very important that we get the right transparency, the right openness. We always say openness is the ratio between the opened and closed surface of a speaker, and transparency is a little bit more. And this means, where is the speaker located behind the grill? How thick is the material? Is it angled? What's the behavior of the cone of influence? I show you something about this in a second. Material properties, and fabrication process, like what kind of material are we using for that speaker? If we have a thick material like a 2 millimeter aluminium, it behaves different as if we are using a very thin sheet of stainless steel or maybe even plastic where there are some reflection inside these all of these holes. So all of these elements, I'm spending a little time explaining this because that is really getting back on us if it's not performing right. So we have developed an algorithm and script for this, and we are basically coding this in Grasshopper, where we're taking all of these elements into account from fabrication, from packaging, acoustics, mechanical requirements, and other material properties, so that once we apply this, that we can control this, and we can make sure at a very early point in time that it is working well. Maybe we need to test it once or twice, but we can avoid numerous loops of iterations. And think about a product. If you have a speaker for your home, there's one product. But if you have a speaker for the vehicle, there are multiple locations, at least one or two grills in the doors, something on the dashboard. So suddenly you end up having 8 to 10 speaker locations, and we always continuously during the development of a vehicle, you need to upgrade these surfaces in the data. So there's a lot of work going into this, and it used to be a bottleneck, but having a script in place has actually improved this process. And it's not only the acoustic elements, but it's also the branding components. So we're shifting also everything that we have learned before about these different packages there. What does it mean to have a brand? What kind of materials do we apply in there? We are bringing these additional bricks into this cake, so that we have really a holistic script, a branded script we call it, that combines technical requirements and branding requirements, and then we can apply this. And I think the next example shows this pretty well. This is actually how we start working on this, where we identify the speaker location behind the grill. We're projecting the cone of influence. It's actually the active area of a speaker on this. And then the script that we're working on, based on the behavior of the material that we apply on this and the angle and stuff like this, it always gives us real-time information about the openness of the grill. And this is really helpful because it gives us real-time feedback about all the options that we are creating. I have this one looping, so we might have a look at this one again. But this is an example how we do this on Harman Kardon. But it's really powerful how we can create multiple options and not just present one of them and then we try it out at a later point in time. But this it's an improved process that we have learned over time, all over again, and it has become better and better. And that's something we're doing for all the brands in our portfolio. But seeing this in 3D is always a little bit misleading. So there's no way around to really produce this. I saw form labs out there. We're having a couple of those machines. We're creating grills. We're testing them for sure then as well in 3D. And we need to analyze really like how's the real-time behavior then. And then there are on some of the brands, especially when we come more in the luxury segment, there are these very iconic, we call them the jewelry items, the crown jewels, maybe. They are sitting on a desktop and they are very, very iconic. And they have a right for existence because the geometry is not just random, but it has it is an acoustic product. The speaker, the shape on top of this one we call the acoustic lens because it's sitting on top of a tweeter speaker, and it's projecting towards the windscreen. And then this little geometry on top of this one is diffusing the sound, and the sound engineers have an opportunity then to create a stage in front of you while you're driving. We have this for these elements. I have an example in a second on JBL, and you might understand how we can have computational design, how we can add this one to these surfaces as well. On JBL, this is where we have the horn tweeter. This is a very iconic element about the product itself. It's also sitting on a tweeter location, and it's a horn that is directing the sound towards the listener. And what we can do now with our algorithms, with a separate script here, is to find the optimal location for that geometry, for that tweeter speaker, for that horn speaker, because that surface here is it needs to be very accurate, very precise, so that it's actually enhancing the performance of that that speaker. What you can see here, it's testing. This is a little bit fast forward. It's a little bit slower, but it's analyzing different locations of possible locations of the tweeter, and it's giving us different results and a different feedback. And we're taking the best values out of this to go in the next loop. And from there, we're getting, you see, it's moving less and less, so it narrows down to the precise location. And this is where the best, where the sweet spot, so to say, is for that tweeter location. Before, it was more a guess, and we had to create the surface, we had to test it, but this one is has continuously developed with the experience we had to create surfaces like this, and I think it's a key element of our design process. And then moving forward, it's not only important to have the physical representation of the product in the car, but also a digital user experience, like everything, how you behave, how the product behaves at home, how you interact with your product. You expect this to happen the same in your car as well. And we have added in our team a motion design team, so we're able to highlight all of these features even better. Not like just a glass vehicle where you see the location of the speakers, but these are elements that we have added, I think, since about a year in our team, where we are more where we're more able to create and show the technologies, the added value that comes with a speaker like this. And for those who are interested, we work in Figma in this one very very much also in with the with our partners, and it's important for us that also in this digital experience, in an app, wherever you have an experience with the product, with the brand, that there is a very close relation to how it appears in the vehicle as well. Sounds obvious, but sometimes it's harder than you think. And then in the end, it's always important to make sure that, like, what we develop, that this is really like the part of the user testing, like, does everything work as it should in the car. Thank you very much.